Hey guys, this is Josh and Natty Know-It-All. I'm coming to you with six tips that I think will help athletes in high school get noticed in the recruiting process. Hey guys, once again, this is Josh and Natty Know-It-All with six things that I think will help athletes get noticed as they start the recruiting process. Guys, this is actually the second video in the series that I'm doing. First video was five things that you need to do as an athlete in high school before you commit to a college. Once again, that's not a complete list of things you need to do, but it's a good starting point. And this one, same thing. There's more than six things you can do to be noticed, but these are six things that I think will really be a good foundation, a good starting point, and a jumping off point as you try and get recruited for colleges to see if you can continue your athletic career. First tip I have for you, make a video. I cannot tell you how many athletes I have talked to who want to be recruited, want to continue playing, and when I say, hey, you know what? Send me a link to your video and I'll retweet it on Twitter, with my thing. I've got a number of college coaches who follow me. Maybe one of them will want to take a look at you. And I've had more than a few people say, I don't have a video. How can a coach see you if you don't even have a video? They're not going to be out there at every single game across the state, the region, the country. There are going to be athletes who don't get seen in person because there's just too many games to go to. Having a video, you can tweet it out to a coach, you can email it to a coach. It's something that they can watch wherever they're at. All they need is their smartphone, their tablet, their computer, whatever it is, they can sit and watch it wherever they are. So having a video made, it doesn't need to be high tech. I mean, let's be honest, guys. Our smartphones do more than enough to be able to create a video. Record yourself hitting in a game. Record yourself pitching or catching or throwing. Whatever you do, just record it. Now, don't record the errors you make, but just have someone, your parents, your friends, your grandparents, your aunts, your uncles, cousins, anyone, just have them record you playing the sport that you play and hope to play at another level. It's a simple thing. Even if it's you in the batting cage or on the mound in the warehouse just throwing, have something to show coaches. It's important, it's easy, it doesn't really cost you anything. And if you have troubles doing that, find someone who knows how to make a simple video. That's all it takes. So the second thing I have for you in order to be noticed is contact coaches. It sounds so simple. It sounds so obvious. And yet, so many athletes think that the only way they're going to get recruited is if a coach comes to their games and watches them play. That's not how it happens. A majority of the time, yes, there are some coaches who have connections with different schools and that type of stuff, and they'll go out and watch games. But a lot of the time, coaches hear about players for the first time because that player emailed them or called them or contacted them in some way to put themselves on that coach's radar. So it's important to take time, find colleges you're interested in, and reach out to those coaches. Now, do understand, know your levels, know what you're looking for. If you're looking for a certain type of education, certain type of major, don't just contact every coach in your region if they don't have the majors you're looking for, because that's one of the things they're going to ask you is what things do you hope to major in? What is your career path that you hope to follow? And if it doesn't match up with their school, then they're not going to recruit you because it doesn't make sense to bring someone in who isn't a good fit for the school overall. So, do some research. I mentioned that in the last video, but go out there and contact coaches. And once again, that's where the video comes in. They may say, hey, I can't get out and watch any of your games because I'm coaching right now. It's the baseball season. But won't you, can you send me a link to a video? Can you send me a video to watch? Those things are important. Contact coaches, get on their radar. A lot of coaches will, take the time to talk with you. In fact, I've known a few coaches who say they respond to every email and every phone call they get from prospective players because they don't want to miss out on a player who's going to help their program grow and get better. So they're going to take the time to look at that, especially if you have a video, it makes it easier for them. So number three, to get noticed, be the biggest and best teammate there is on your high school team. Be the cheerleader. When a guy is having troubles, be the one who pumps them up, gets them involved, gets them excited to play the game. Coaches notice that. When coaches are out recruiting, when they do have the time to go out and watch a game, whether it's in the spring or in the summertime where they have more time to go attend more of the showcases and tournaments and that type of stuff, if there is a coach there and they see you being the teammate who is not only performing on the field, but making every effort to help his teammates be the best they can be, that makes a difference. That makes a huge difference because then they know that if they do recruit you, they're bringing in a guy who's going to emphasize making their team winner, a better team, making their team a winning team by uniting each other together into one family. So it does help. I mean, if guys are out there bashing their teammates and just tearing them apart, coaches don't want that. That's a cancer. That takes a team that could be a winning team and drops them down a level. So coaches want to see good teammates. They want to see guys who care about the overall team's success and are there cheering each other on. It makes a difference. It does leave a big impression on college coaches. So be that teammate who is constantly talking, constantly cheering guys up, constantly saying, "You got it, you got it." Be that teammate. It's okay. That's what college coaches want. Go watch a college game and listen to the teams that win. They are constantly talking to their teammates, constantly out there. So be that person. It's a good thing. Okay, tip number four, and this one also should be a no-brainer, but respond to the coaches who communicate with you. A lot of athletes will get a message, a call, an email, or something from a coach, and they'll ghost them. They'll just not respond. They'll kind of treat the whole thing like, "Oh, I'm too good for your school." Don't do that. Don't do that. Even if your response is as simple as saying, "Hey, thank you for reaching out to me. I don't know that your college or your university is the best fit for what I'm looking for, but I do appreciate you taking the time. It means a lot to me." That means a lot to a coach because one, they know that they can then focus their attention on other players. But then it also knows that you have enough respect for them to say, "Hey, I appreciate it, but we're not a good fit." And maybe down the line, let's say you go to a college, after 1 year you realize, "Whoa, this is not a good fit. I need to transfer someone else, some to another college, another university." You may go back to that coach and say, "Hey, coach, I didn't think we were a good fit. I went somewhere else, realized, whoa, that wasn't a good fit. I think you are the good fit. Can I have a second chance? Can I play for you?" Coaches who see you as being respectful and being someone who takes initiative to even say, "Hey, I'm sorry, we're not a good fit," they'll give you a second chance. They'll talk with you. But if you ghost them and don't interact with them and you just kind of ignore them altogether, you're going to lose that chance to fall back. If something ever happened, you need to transfer out or maybe you go to a school and their baseball program gets cut. Happens quite a bit, actually. You need to know that you were respectful enough to all these other coaches that you can go back to them and say, "Hey, I'm reconsidering where I'm at. Can I talk with you about it?" It's important to respond and interact with them. And especially if you've gotten offers from schools and you've selected which school you want to go to, before you put it on social media that you've accepted this offer, contact every other school that's offered you and say, "Hey, thank you for this, but I've decided to go with this school instead." That is huge. Once again, it shows a level of respect. And if you go, let's say you go to a D1 school, after your freshman year, you decide to transfer back to a junior college. If you've treated those junior college coaches with respect, they will welcome you with open arms. They will be excited to have you back playing for them. It's true. I see it all the time. Guys who are respectful, they get welcomed back and they get second chances, another opportunity. So tip number five I have for you to be noticed, play the game. Get out there and play. Play for your high school. Play in the summer. Now don't overdo it. Don't sit and play 10 games a week and make it so much that you're just physically exhausted and mentally wore out. Don't do that to yourself, but go out there and play. You never know when you're at a showcase, the right coach at the right time might see you do the right thing and decide to, you know, talk with you, see what you're made of, see who you are, see what you're interested in. Go out there and play and give it your all and have fun. Have fun. You're playing a game and you have a chance to possibly play at college and get some of your tuition paid for. Have fun. Go out and play. Go play. Enjoy it. Because when you get to my age, I'm almost 40, you don't get to play. You don't get to go out there and play the game you love. You get to watch it. You get to photograph it, talk about it, but you don't get to play it. Enjoy it now. Go out there and play and play and have fun. Enjoy the game. So tip number six, last one I got for you to help you get noticed, and that's use social media as a recruiting tool. Now, a lot of high schoolers will have social media and they use it as a social tool. They interact with their friends, and that's great. If that's what you want, that's fine. That's great. That's social media. That's what it's called. That's what it's for. But you can also use it as a recruiting tool. It's a place where you can put videos, a place where you can put stats, photographs. I mean, every little bit can help you, especially if college coaches, they're going to be checking things. Now, be aware, social media can be great. It can also be horrible. If you go on there and you're making comments that, well, are racist or just negative or hurtful or threatening, man, you want to see how fast a college coach can run away from a high school athlete? Just do that. They will scatter and you will not hear a thing. So make sure if you use social media, you're doing it in a positive way. When you're talking about your teammates, your other coaches, that you are saying positive things all the time. Even if you're having an issue with a teammate, don't take it to social media. Not the place for it. Don't do that. Just avoid it altogether. You got to stay positive on social media because you have to understand college coaches do look at that. I mean, heck, even when you're applying for jobs, you get scouted by your potential employers. I know because I used to do that. I was in charge of hiring in my last job, and there was more than a few times where I would just accidentally get onto Facebook and accidentally type in someone's name to see if I could see what type of person they are. It does happen all the time. Be aware, be smart with social media. It can be an amazing tool. It can be an amazing way to connect with coaches and teams and colleges all across the nation. Take advantage of what you have. So guys, once again, that was just six tips on how to be noticed in the recruiting process. They're simple tips. There's nothing difficult about the six things I had, but yet those things get overlooked all the time. I have guys who have failed to communicate with any coaches and they wonder why they don't have a chance to play college ball. You have to take the initiative. You have to step out there and show coaches who you are and that you are interested. So that they know that they take the time to look into you and your skills and your interest, that it's not just a waste of time for them. So guys, once again, I'm Josh, the 90 Know-It-All, coming to you with six tips on how to get noticed in the recruiting process. And be aware, I've got more videos about the recruiting process coming out soon. I don't know when, but I've got at least two more that I'm making. And honestly, I've got a few other ones that I'm thinking about making and I'll probably end up making. So this series could be 4, it could be 10 videos long. I have no idea. But it's fun. I'm enjoying it, and I hope this helps. Talk to you guys later.